Good morning, Fehmina Khan is here in TK Maths S1. In today's video, I will explain to you a concept of angles with respect to triangle and other polygons. This is a topic which is a part of the syllabus of O-level mathematics. To explain this concept, I have picked up a question from November 4, variant 1, question number 20. So before we begin, you can see on the top my website address and my blog address. The blog address has all the videos I have made so far. They are organized very well. You can get help from there. And on my website, I am offering a checklist for exam preparation, challenging question solution, and there are other informations which can help you in your learning process. So let's begin with the question. The first information is that the interior angle of a regular polygon is 160. Now you need to know what is polygon. Polygon is any closed figure by straight line. So triangle is a polygon. Sorry, the picture is a little wrong here. The quadrilateral, any quadrilateral, square, kite, or pentagon, hexagon, all those figures which are closed by straight lines is called polygon. Regular mean all sides equal and all angle and sides are equal. So a square is a regular polygon, right? So when question is saying it is a regular polygon and one interior angle is 160, how many sides it will be? For example, if I make it, I don't know, because angle is 160. So this is what we have to find out. So let's recall few formula here first, and then we will solve this question. We know in case of regular polygon, some of the angles, some of all the angles which are inside the polygon, like here, this, this, some can be calculated with the help of this formula, n minus 2 multiplied by 180. And if you have to find out, because this will give you the sum, right? N represents number of sides. So if I say one interior angle, it means once you find out the sum, just divide it by the number of sides. For example, if I see in square, it is 4, right? So if I write here 4, so it will be 4 minus 2 is 2. 2 into 180 is 360, and 360 divided by 4. So it will be 90. So this is what I'm saying, this is the formula for finding one interior angle, and this is for the sum of interior angle. Now here we are given that one interior angle of a regular polygon is 160. It means this thing is equals to 160. And then you will solve it like algebra, and you will get the answer. So let's solve it, because we have to find out how many sides it has. So simple algebraic calculation, and you will find out that there are 18 sides of a regular polygon, which is making one interior angle equals to 160 degree. Let's see the second part of the question. Now this figure is given to you here, right? And two pieces of information. Number one, A, B, C, D, E, dash, dash. It means they have not completed the picture here, right? Like this. It is only a part of the picture is given. And it is the same polygon we are talking about in part one. So each interior angle is 160. So if you see the line AB and BC, it means this angle is 160. If you see the line BC and CD, so this is the interior angle, this is 160. If you see CD and DE, then this is 160. So this is one piece of information, and it is saying CDLM means this is a square. Now if this is a square, we know the sides are all equal, right? Because in a square, sides are equal. And at the same time, it is a regular polygon, so these sides are also same, all equal, right? So this is the information you are getting from here. We have to find out the value of x and y. So what information you have and how can you find x and y? So let's see. Now this red is 90 degree, right? Because it is a square. And this hole is 160 because this is an interior angle. So to find out x, it is simple. That you simply multiply, minus 90 from 160. So you will get your x. Now the question is how you will find out this y. Do you know this angle? How can you find this angle? But you have very important information here, and that is this side BC and CM are equal, right? Because of square, this is all same, and because of regular polygon, each side is same. So what type of triangle do you get here? It is an isosceles triangle because two sides are equal. So now if you see here, I have just drawn this triangle BCM here separately to explain it to you, BCM, right? This angle is 70. We have just found the value of x, 160 minus 90 is 70. And because it is an isosceles triangle, so these two angles are equal. We don't know right now, so we can call them A. So I can apply the property of sum of the triangle of angles of triangle. So 2A plus 70 equals to 180. So I found the value of A, 55, right? So it means this angle is 55. If this angle is 55 and this whole is 160, so can you find Y now? Yes, very easily. So Y is equals to 160 minus A, and A is 55. So you can easily find out the value of Y. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have learned something from it. If you liked it, press like and subscribe button. Do share it with your friends. Thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.